Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Cadet Student Network's broadcast of CBC Basketball live from the DC Wilcutt Basketball Tournament. Tournament tips off with the host and top-seeded Cadets taking on the Crusaders of Lutheran North High School. You can see the Lutheran North being introduced right now with their starting lineups. CSN will broadcast all games of this three-day tournament. We thank the CBC students behind the scenes who are helping to bring you the live action. My name's Randy Molman. My broadcast partner for today is CBC Admissions Director Jim Brockman. We're looking forward to a great week of basketball here. And Jim, the Cadets come off a big win against SLU on Friday, Mater Day on Saturday at the Highland Shootout.
Yeah, huge weekend, Randy. Big weekend for the Cadets. It was a gutty performance on Friday night. You know, the Cadets really trailed most of the game on Friday night to a real gritty and upstart group of SLU Billikens. Obviously, you've got a conference rivalry game. You've got a historic rivalry game. All of these old alums love to beat the U-High. We trailed most of the game. And really only in the last 5 minutes were we able to pull away for a pretty hard-fought conference victory, which is what you'd expect in conference.
That's right, and CBC's offense always runs through Jordan Barnes. He had a big, big game against SLU, didn't he?
Yeah, huge game, huge weekend for Jordan Barnes. Just an awesome kid. Had 28 points with 7 three-pointers against SLU. Really the catalyst for the home win against the Billikens. And then followed that up against Mater Dei on Saturday. And again, it's so hard to come back on that, you know. Followed that up against Mater Dei with an opening 9 points in the first quarter. Really got us off to a good start against Mater Dei on Saturday. These Cadets are playing good basketball right now.
So the starting lineups for the Lutheran North Crusaders, they will have Christian Gauss, number 23, Kyle Goldman, number 24, number 30, Brandon Sumrall, number 32, Malik Mingo, and number 34, Barry Dorsey. And Jim, you want to tell us who the starters are for CBC?
Yeah, for the Cadets, we've got a great, again, going with our traditional lineup for the Cadets here. Starting out, as you mentioned, Jordan Barnes, number 4, Kenny Leslie, number 33, Christian Willis, the junior, the MVP of the tournament this weekend. Of course, you've got Nick Wheeler and then Jarek Pollitt, the other guard.
So CBC wins the tip. Barnes now will stand back at the free throw line as he dribbles, as the offense gets to set. He sends it now over to number 10, Jarek Powell. Powell back to Barnes over on the high left wing, down into the corner now for Wheeler. Wheeler back underneath. That's Willis from just inside the free throw line. 2 points for Christian Willis, CBC on the board.
Yeah, and that's what you're looking for right there, Randy. You get a good set piece in there. You get one of your go-to guys, Christian Willis, averaging 15 points a game. You get him an open look from the free throw line. Couldn't ask for much more.
Lutheran North now trying to penetrate here. Out at the elbow. It's knocked away. Good defense by the Cadets, but it's still grabbed there by Kyle Goldman, number 24.
Yeah,
down low, we're going to get an injury timeout, official timeout.
That Jarek Powell's got some of the fastest hands in the conference. You watch him. He's a standout track star in the spring, but Jarek has got some of the best hands. This is a huge pickup for Coach Tatum with this year. You know, Jarek played as a freshman, didn't play as a sophomore to concentrate on track and field. Now he's back again, and he is just an absolute awesome pickup.
So Lutheran South now, the injury was to number 30, Brandon Sumrall. He leaves. Checking in is number 3, Derek Henderson. It looked like Henderson will play the point. That ball is back and returned by number 24, Goldman.
Watch the on the ball defense by Jarek Powell. They put him on one of the fastest guys, Derek Henderson, for Lutheran North. He is a tremendous on-the-ball defender.
This is now Gauss at the right wing. He sends it back over to number 3, Henderson, who just checked in for Sumrall. Dribbles to the left side. Now he'll bring it back to the right side looking, and we're going to get a foul called.
Illegal moving screen there. That's a point of emphasis here in amongst high school basketball. Those moving screens where the screener hedges out and either hip checks or knee checks a guy. That has been a point of emphasis this year for our referees.
Malik Mingo picks up the foul, and now CBC will come back. Jordan Barnes down low to Leslie from the right wing, and he misses. And it's rebounded by number 24, Goldman. Goldman now will give it to Henderson coming back for the Crusaders. over to the right side now, sends it down to the low post. And it's stolen. Jordan Barnes with his left hand knocked it free, took it with the right, and it's a right-hand dribble all the way up the court. Now for three from the right wing, no good. Bounces off and rebounded there by Goldman.
Yeah, Henderson's the leading scorer for Lutheran North, so look for him to be involved early. If you're Coach Lowe for Lutheran North, you want Henderson to get involved right away here.
Henderson now over to Gauss. Gauss back to Henderson. Henderson, 9.6 per game. Dorsey and Gauss both averaging 9.3, so pretty balanced offense.
Yeah, very well distributed, and you like that. Definitely like that, as you see Henderson missed the shot there.
Missed the three, and Barnes will come back the other way for the Cadets. Down to Leslie, and it kicks off his right hand and bounces out of bounds. Yeah, it'll be a turnover.
Ill-advised shot, or ill-advised pass there by Jarek Powell. Kenny was still getting his post and threw it right at his feet off his foot into the first row.
Henderson will bring it up now for Lutheran North. He'll drive into the lane and kick it out for three, and it is good. 3 points there for Christian Gauss from the left wing, and it's 3-2 Lutheran North.
Yeah, Gauss only shoots it from about 17% from the three, but that was got a good look, good open look, and lost him in transition and was able to knock it down.
Gauss will now rush the ball up for the Crusaders. He kicks it over to the right wing, driving into the paint. No good. Blocked by Leslie. Good job there. And here comes CBC. Pulling that one down was Nick Wheeler after the block by Leslie. Barnes in the left corner, looking to feed somebody. He'll kick it back out to Willis. The thing about Christian Willis, I've always noticed, for a bigger player, he is so versatile. He can play the point. He can play down low.
And that's one of the things Coach Tatum really likes about him. That's one of the things a lot of these colleges that are looking at him like about him, too, is you can put him at a 1-2 or potentially a 3. You can put him at a 4 even. He'll bang for rebounds. He's like a junkyard dog. He just loves to get those rebounds. He is fearless on the way to the basket. He's a fun player to watch.
My name's Randy Molman alongside Jim Brockman. It is the DC Wilcutt Tournament, game one of the tournament, and the Cadets and Lutheran North Crusaders. It's a 3-2 lead for the Crusaders with 4:34 to play here in the first quarter.
This is a dangerous game for the Cadets simply because they came off a big weekend, a lot of games. They played very good basketball this weekend, and now they're getting an early game here, Randy. They're not used to playing at 3:30, so they get the early game of the tournament here, and you can maybe see a little malaise on their right now.
Barnes fed Foxworth, who had just checked in, for 2 points there, and it's 4-3 CBC.
Another big pickup with Foxworth, really getting him in shape. Jacob also played his freshman year, now back as a junior. Great kid, great addition to the team.
Save there, and here comes Lutheran North back up right into the paint. They let him free, and the foul is called. Count the basket for number 23, Gauss. He now has 5 points.
You really got to step on that. I mean, that again, I don't know if Jacob got lost in transition there or what, but you really got to step up and defend that guy. Clearly one of their leading scorers here. So you got to make sure you get him. He drove it right to the basket, went up over Jacob, and laid it in for the traditional attempt for three-point play.
Free throw is no good for Gauss.
You see Ketching's checked into the game now. Yep. You get the freshman into the game. You get Blake Bomarito into the game here. See if you can shake it up a little bit. It looks like the Cadets are just a little lethargic right now.
Willis kicks it to Barnes. Barnes at the right at the free throw line. A beautiful pass to Christian Willis, who drains it. He now has 4.
That was the opening play of the game. They ran the exact same play for the exact same guy, and he knocked it down again.
6-5 now. CBC, 3:23 and counting, first quarter. This is Henderson, the Crusaders' leading scorer. He'll dribble with the left hand into the paint. He'll try, but Jordan Barnes got him from behind, and then he's fouled by number 32. Malik Mingo is going to get called for his second.
Yeah, that's a problem for a short bench that Lutheran North has. Getting two for a guy in the really in the first, 5 minutes of the game is problematic. Otherwise, short bench for Lutheran North.
Austin Betts checks in, and Austin Betts averaging 5.3 per game for Lutheran North.
You know, one of the really underrated parts of Jordan Barnes' games is his defense. Everybody knows he's got handles. Everybody knows he can score and slash, and he can shoot. But what people don't talk about is his ability to defend.
Look at Foxworth fighting for rebounds, and they're going to get a foul on number 24. It looks like Kyle Goldman. And Foxworth just using that big body to bang for rebounds underneath there.
Yeah, that's a big asset for Jacob. And Jacob's getting back into basketball here, getting his basketball legs together.
Christian Willis on the inbound play. Set play there, and Willis leads all scorers with 6 points.
Yeah, quick six for Christian Willis. Love to see him get involved early. Really sets the tone for this team. He and Barnes really are the catalyst for this team.
Here. Henderson with a missed pass, and here comes Catchings the other way for CBC, and he'll lay it in. The freshman.
Yeah, Cale's real long. He's got a lot of energy. Really, really smart kid. Really good addition. Good guy coming off the bench.
Cale Catchings. There's another steal. Barnes to Catchings into the paint with the right hand. Just a little short. Willis, of course, grabs the rebound. Nope. He's not fouled. The ball will go out of bounds, and CBC will retain possession.
Yeah, if you're keeping score at home, that's three steals in the first quarter for Jordan Barnes right now. And, again, back to my point that he really is an underrated defender. I love to watch him in the open court when he – you know, we typically put him on the fastest, most athletic guy out at the top, and he accepts that challenge.
Now this is Barnes trying to feed it to Catchings, and it's stolen. Nice defensive play there by Gauss, who has scored all five of Lutheran North's points. Henderson now will drive in, take the shot. It's blocked partially by Bomarito. Seemed like a late whistle there.
Yeah, I don't know if he felt like he got him with the body. Apparently he did, because I thought he was partially blocked up top, but might have got him down low. And, you know, Henderson ended up on the floor. Usually is a recipe for a foul.
Henderson now will shoot two. He makes the first one.
You know, credit Lutheran North here, coming again to an environment, again, they had a bus ride over here. They're playing the early game. They've really hung tough here early.
One of two there for Henderson, shooting 87% from the line coming in. Bomarito for three from the corner, and that's what he does. He nails the three from the down in the left corner, and it's 13-6. CBC.
Interesting lineup here, Randy, for the Cadets. You've got two big guys in the middle with Cale and Kenny Leslie, and then you got two shooters on the wings in Sam Orff and Blake Bomarito.
Good play there by Kyle Goldman. He fought through after he took the pass after they pressured the corner, took the pass, almost had it stolen, drove in, and drew the foul, and that foul was called on Leslie. That'll be his first. Third team foul called on CBC.
Goldman's very effective in the paint for this Lutheran North team. Most of his shots will come inside the paint or right around that area there, although he misses the free throw.
Misses that first one.
You know, and Randy, for Lutheran North to stay with these guys, they're definitely going to have to make free throws, and I think they're 1-for-4 right now. They're 2-for-5 now from the line. That's going to be a key for them to stay in this game.
That will be Catchings back in. On his side of the floor, they get it up to Sam Orff now. Orff to Barnes. Barnes looking top of the key. Gets it down to Orff for three from the corner. No good. Rattles out. Grabbed by Leslie. Offensive rebound. Put back with the left hand.
Well, it's fun when you're a shooter out there and you know you're going to get a second crack because you got a guy like Kenny Leslie or a guy like Christian Willis in the paint grabbing rebounds for you.
This is now Gauss. He'll drive in with the left hand down to the baseline, looking, passes it back underneath to Goldman. Goldman tries to grab it. CBC on the floor. Goldman retains possession. Should have gotten rid of it, and yeah. It's knocked away by Orff, but it'll stay with Lutheran North.
Heck of a job by Kyle Goldman on the floor, fighting for the ball. Like you said, should have gotten rid of it and didn't, was able to keep it alive, and then was deflected out of bounds by the Cadets.
Barnes will take a break, and as you know, Willis can play the point, and he'll come in and play it now. There's a three from the corner. Nice shot there by number 34, Barry Dorsey, who buries the three from the right wing.
Yeah, that was a good set piece by Lutheran North. They're down five here with 30 seconds to go.
Catchings on the right baseline misses. Goldman grabs the rebound and hands it to Henderson. Here comes Derek Henderson, and he moves. What a great play. And then a great block by Catchings.
You know, good for Cale Catchings. Might have taken a quick shot down at the other end there. Got back on defense, made a great defensive play, and the Cadets will hold for a final shot here.
Henderson set it up beautifully by faking Orff and then fed it down low to Betts, but Catchings with the block. Great block. 4 seconds to go here in the quarter. Henderson's going to cross the timeline. He better put it up. He does at the buzzer, and it's off the back iron. No good. So it's 15-10 here at the end of the first quarter. You're watching CBC Basketball on the Cadet Student Network. We are live from the DC Wilcutt Tournament. Tonight's tip was sponsored by State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo. Tim takes care of CBC. He'll take care of you too. So that's Tim at Tim Kylo, KILO.com. CBC would also like to thank all the teams competing this week as we honor DC Wilcutt, a legendary coach, educator, and administrator who spent 35 years at CBC. During his career, Coach Wilcutt led the Cadets to 3 state titles, 14 district championships, and a total of 570 wins. He's a member of the Missouri Coaches Hall of Fame. Most important, Coach was a mentor and a friend to so many during his time at CBC. We're so grateful for all he gave to CBC. And Jim, any stories you could share a little bit real quick about DC Wilcutt?
If you talk to anybody who knows Coach Wilcutt, they'll tell you one word sums him up. It's gentleman. He is an absolute gentleman, consummate professional, was always about the right things, cared deeply about his players and his students, just a tremendous man. One that you want to put around young men in order for them to emulate as they grow up. Just a great man. We couldn't be more proud to have this tournament named after a gentleman. You know, it's been as big of a historical figure in the history of CBC. 165 years history of CBC. There's been some great men that have come through this place, and he's one of them. He's at the top of the list.
570 wins. That's racking them up right there.
Yeah, that's a lot of basketball.
That's time and success, isn't it?
Absolutely.
All right, Derek Henderson now will take the inbound for Lutheran North. He'll go down the right wing and pass it off to, well, it's back to Henderson now, who tries a three. It's off the front rim, and Leslie fights for the rebound with Goldman. They both went up for it. Leslie comes down with it, and here comes Sam Orff the other way. He'll get it over to Bomarito. Back to Orff. Orff now looking for Willis. Willis will bring it back out and send it down to Leslie down on the right block, and underneath, yep. Kale catching smooth.
Another great set piece there. I mean, that's one of the advantages of having Leslie being able to step out a little bit is you get Kale catching slashing down the lane. Oh.
Henderson again with a nice feed. Catchings blocks Betts once again. Betts has called for the travel, and Catchings has Betts' number right now.
Yeah, he does. Well, I tell you what, Kale has really, really made an impact in this game just in the short time he's been in there. It's a great thing having a guy like him coming off the bench. He can handle the rock a little bit. He can shoot a little bit. He rebounds. He defends.
Willis is blocked as Betts returns the favor, and here comes Gauss the other way. He'll hand it to Henderson. Good move from the left baseline. No good, and it's pulled down by Christian Willis. He'll bring it back for CBC. Henderson pressures him. Willis with a spin move. Kept his foot, and now this is Bomarito trying to bury a three. Can't do it. That'll go off of Goldman and stay with CBC. Catchings once again, a nice move.
I wonder if there were some words said at half or at the quarter there. I mean, these guys, both teams have come out with some energy here, running up and down the court a little bit. It's fun to see.
Powell and Wheeler return for CBC. Catchings and Bomarito will go take a rest. Orff inbounds to Willis. Back to Orff. He almost fired the three. Gets it back to Willis. Now they'll set it up. Willis across to Powell on the near side. CBC going from your left to your right. All white home uniforms with the purple and gold trim. Leslie with the left hand down along the baseline off the glass. No good. Betts grabbed the rebound, and he feeds Gauss coming the other way for the Crusaders.
Well defended by Betts there. He went straight up, jumped out of the gym, went straight up. Didn't lean in, didn't grab, went straight up. It was great.
Some frenetic play here as no one can really get a stronghold on the ball. The ball's bouncing around like a hot potato. They're going to call a foul there. And it looks like they're going to get.
Yeah, I didn't see who they got there. Looks like they got, it says,
yep,
oh,
number 10.
There we go. Yeah. That was Jarek Powell there.
Jarek Powell gets the foul call.
Well, and you see Tatum now. I think Tatum wants to settle this down a little bit, bringing Jordan Barnes back into the game to really, I mean, just he's just a floor general.
Barnes to Leslie with the right hand. No good. Tip, no good. And the ball bounces off a Lutheran North player and goes out of bounds. CBC will inbound underneath the basket.
Yeah, good follow by Nick Wheeler there. Just couldn't get it to go, and then stayed with it, and Lutheran North had to swipe it away, went out of bounds.
Returning for Lutheran North, or checking in, number 21. That's Barion Russell Clemens.
Yeah, it looked like a travel on Kenny.
Yep,
he took
travel.
Took a little, I think they call that a European step, right before he put the ball on the floor. I mean, back in our day, they called it a travel, but, you know, whatever. So.
Is there a different sign for a European step?
Yeah, I will have to look that up in the rule book. Maybe a point of emphasis.
Gauss with the floater. Right-handed floater for Gauss. He now has 7. CBC the other way. Willis to Barnes. Back to Willis. He's going to fire up the 3 from the far side. No good. Long rebound for CBC. Grabbed by Powell. Powell back to Barnes. He'll settle things down now. 5:22 and counting. First half. 17-12 CBC.
Yeah, that's a good move by Barnes, just to slow this down a little bit.
Barnes back across, now underneath to Leslie, turns, fires it back to Barnes, sets him up for the 3, and he buries it. What a set right there, and Barnes nails it wide open from the right wing.
Yeah, great look from the inside by Leslie, and got it back out to Barnes, and Barnes was able to knock the shot down. And Wheeler with the steal.
And here comes CBC the other way. Barnes to Leslie for the alley-oop, and CBC taking firm control of this one.
Yeah, Luther North's going to need to get a timeout here, I think. I think he needs to settle his players down.
Henderson with a good feed to Betts.
Yeah, quick back. Yeah, the big senior. Oh, another one.
Here we go again. Oh, and that one, that time it's blocked. Lutheran North was ready. Betts was ready for that one, but they almost pulled off 2 in a row.
Yeah, it's fun. You got to have your head up when Jordan Barnes got the ball in his hand. It could come from anywhere.
Henderson with some nifty ball work. Wow. Henderson to Betts for 2. I am impressed thus far with Derek Henderson, Jim.
Yeah, he is silky smooth. He's got some handles on him. We got a little and one in him maybe. And if you're not paying attention, he's going to cross you up.
Timeout called on the floor now as Goldman had grabbed the ball, and Lutheran North will call the timeout from the bench, and they'll talk it over a little bit. It was 22-12. Lutheran North not going away, as they just scored 2 points or 4 points.
I'm telling you, Randy,
this is a 6-point game.
Yeah, you know what? And again, I think. You know, when you do have a team that it has probably superior talent, they can sometimes fall into the trap of trying to run and gun and maybe alley-oop it a few too many times. Whereas if you just play solid basketball, half-court offense, we can run offense all day, get yourself quality looks and establish yourself. I think if I'm Lutheran North, this is what I want. I want CBC to try to run with me a little bit. I want to get a little street ball into the game here to take CBC out of what they do so well, which is running offense.
It's 22-16, 4:07 remaining first half. You're watching CBC Basketball on the Cadet Student Network. My name's Randy Molman alongside CBC Director of Admissions Jim Brockman, who is kind enough to join me today. And the Cadets, 22-16 so far, 6 points for Christian Willis, and then Catchings and Leslie with 4 each for CBC. Jordan Barnes with only 3 points, but you know that's not going to stay that way for long. At some point, Jordan Barnes is going to go on a run for this cadet squad.
Yeah, he has the ability to get explosive pretty quickly. He's got 3 steals, so he has made his impact felt. He took Coach Tatum sat him down for the second part of the first quarter and then for the first part of the second quarter, so I'd imagine he's going to insert his will here a little bit more.
Goldman now, and Gauss over to Henderson from the left wing, dribbles in at the elbow, and he can't get the shot. Foxworth almost had control of it. It bounced behind him and went out of bounds, and now Lutheran North retains possession and will inbound underneath CBC's basket.
Yeah, Henderson's got some handles, man. He's fun to watch. He's got the shot fake. One thing is for certain, you got to stay on your feet when he's got the ball.
He's one of those guys you've got to stare in the midsection when you're defending him, because if you start watching his feet, he's going to make you look silly.
Yeah, they always say that in football, the hips don't lie, right?
Yep.
Wherever his belly button goes, he's going.
Betts for 3 from the corner off the front rim, and Henderson with the long rebound kicks it back out. Another 3 ball, and that one goes down. That was Barion Russell Clemens who nails the 3. He came in.
Yeah, Russell Clemens is really, this is his first game.
Yeah,
first
according to the stats on STL Today, he doesn't have any statistics, so he buried that 3. Yeah. Nice work there.
Well, and it was off kind of a broken play there.
Willis with the no look behind the back to Foxworth. Are you kidding me?
Wow.
And we'll go with the old-fashioned and one here for Foxworth to try to complete the 3-point play. Wow. Willis in one move, grabbed the rebound, no looked with his right hand, perfect pass to Foxworth, who put it up and in.
Wrapped it right around the defender. I thought he was going to call a timeout there. He's going out of bounds. He got a little deep, and Foxworth was right there and laid it in. The old three-point play there gives the Cadets a 5-6 point lead now.
The foul was called on Gauss. Four team fouls each. That ball's off Leslie, but he grabs it. He'll send it ahead to Catchings. Oh, what a move. Kale Catchings with two more. That's six. And Leslie and that CBC swarming defense really made that play.
Yeah, this little half-court trap here. You got so many active hands, long limbs. You got to really be strong with the ball.
Betts now from the left wing. He drives along the baseline with the right hand off the glass. No good. Foxworth yanks it down. And here comes CBC the other way. Jordan Barnes will bring it up the floor for the Cadets. Barnes, Powell, Catchings, Foxworth, and Leslie on the floor right now for CBC. Powell's going to fire up a three off the back iron. No good. Long rebound. Uh-oh. Leslie turns around. He is blocked. Wow, Betts. Betts is active underneath on both sides. He's got two straight blocks now on CBC post plays.
Yeah, Betts has been – oh. Oh.
Henderson, that was just lack of focus right there from Derek Henderson.
Ouch, that one hurts. You get a tremendous defensive effort by Betts on one side of the floor, and then you give it away like that. You know, Betts has been really good. He's really held his own against highly recruited Kenny Leslie down in the on the offensive side.
Amarito now will come back. He'll send it over to Barnes. Barnes looks high post now for Catchings underneath the Foxworth. Turns around. Good move. And no good there. Rebound Willis. Willis will put it up, and he's fouled. He'll go to the free throw line.
Yeah, there it is. Again, that junkyard dog. He's there, man. He knows what he's there for. He is just a tough, tough customer under the basket. And he knows how to get it back up quick, not bring it down. He takes it right back up.
Kyle Goldman called with the foul. This is the first free throw attempts for CBC here in the first half. Willis hits the first one.
Yeah, that's interesting too, because while they do shoot it a little bit, they are a slashing team as well.
28-19 the score, trying to put CBC up by 10 is Christian Willis, and he does so. That gives him 8 points on the night for the Cadets.
Yeah, that certainly escalated quickly. It seemed like just a few seconds ago we were talking about a four-point lead, and now it's up to 10. They can score in bunches.
Barnes now guarding Henderson. Henderson to Gauss now, hero on the left wing. Crossover dribble, drives in, and that ball is up in the air. Good defending by CBC. Active hands. Barnes to Bomarito. He shoots it back across to Willis. Willis to Catchings. In the paint with the right hand. How about that floater?
He does not play like a freshman. It is just absolutely impressive. The 6'5 freshman, Kale Catchings. That is just a heck of a play there.
Very smooth. Henderson now drives to the elbow, kicks it back out to Gauss. Gauss back to Henderson now, down low on the left side. Good move. He caught Catchings.
Yeah.
And he draws the foul.
Caught him flat-footed there and kind of came out, but a guy like Henderson's going to blow right by you if you come out flat-footed.
Second foul called on Catchings. Fifth team foul called on CBC. Both teams with five team fouls. No one in serious foul trouble yet. Gauss back to Henderson, and Henderson will run it down. And he hits it off Bomarito. Bomarito almost made a great play with his hands there. That would have been impressive.
That would have been impressive. We got out there, he maybe got away with a little shove there right on the sideline. But nonetheless, good job by Henderson to throw it off Bomarito before he went out of bounds.
Lee Richmond will check in for CBC, his first minutes of this afternoon's game.
Lee's a fun player. He's very active, very long. They bring him in a situation like this. He's got a lot of hands. A lot of arms waiting to slap it away.
Henderson, crossover in, left hand off the glass. This Derek Henderson is tough to watch.
Yeah, he is a very, very electric player here. I mean, I certainly seen him shake. He shook Barnes earlier, shook Orff earlier, now Lee Richmond, and he gets to the hoop so well. It's pretty impressive.
Foul was called on Wheeler. Henderson will shoot free throws, makes the first one.
He's an excellent free throw shooter, shooting at an 87% clip here.
With this free throw, that gives him, he's now 3 of 4 from the line. All 3 points for Henderson at the line so far.
He's had a major impact on this game, but not from the point category, but more from handling the ball and creating opportunities for other people.
Bomarito Looks like CBC will try to play for that last shot. Up 10 points, 20 seconds now and counting here in the first half.
Yeah, you've got enough ball handlers out there that you could probably hold it for the duration of this clock and get the last shot at the half.
My guess is going to be they'll set something up for Bomarito to fire a long three. What do you think about that?
I like it.
Orff and Bomarito. Ooh, good move there by Orff. And he almost drilled it. Foxworth grabs the rebound, but he won't be able to put it up. They set it up for Orff, who tried to drill it, and it went off the back iron. It is a 31-21 CBC lead. As we go to halftime, they lead the Lutheran North Crusaders. Before we go to our halftime video, Cadet fans, are you protected? Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all of your insurance needs. Tim is more than just the best insurance guy in town. He's also the presenting sponsor of the Cadet Student Network. We're incredibly grateful for his support. So call Tim, 314-842-4442, or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. Any thoughts here as we head into halftime on the first half, Jim?
You know, if I'm Lutheran North, I'm not totally disappointed right now. Certainly we're down 10. That's a big deficit to overcome in the second half. But we've hung tough. We've done some good things. We've missed some chippies. I would say one or two chippies that we've missed right by the basket. But we've got the ability, we feel like, to maybe cut into this lead, this 10-point lead. They've got to make free throws. They've got to make their little bunnies. And if they can make free throws and make their layups, they're right in this thing.
So it's 31-21 CBC. That's Jim Brockman. My name's Randy Molman. You are watching the first game of the DC Wilcutt Tournament. We'll be broadcasting all three CBC games here from the DC Wilcutt Tournament. You're watching CBC Basketball on the Cadet Student Network. And the Stand Up for CBC campaign is in full swing. We've gotten a great response from our alums and supporters who are helping CBC prepare to educate the next generation of cadets. Take a look at our campaign video and consider making a donation.
Stand up for CBC, stand up for community, I said stand up for integrity, stand up for CBC. I am one, not the only one, who can do everything. What I can do, I will do, by the grace of God, for my school, God, for us all. Christian brothers on the move. Stand up for CBC, stand up for community, I said stand up for integrity, stand up for CBC, stand up.
Great things happening at CBC every day. Please visit www.standupforcbc.org to make your donation to this exceptional institution. Now is the time to stand up for CBC. It is halftime here at DC Wilcutt Gymnasium at the DC Wilcutt Tournament. CBC leads Lutheran North 31-21. We'll be back with the second half in just a few minutes.
Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim and the State Farm team provide a full insurance review to make sure you and your family are covered at the best possible price. Whether it's auto, renters, home, business, or life insurance, for more than 23 years, Tim has helped his clients manage the risks of everyday life and realize their dreams. For all your insurance needs, contact one of our school's most loyal alums, Class of 77 graduate Tim Kylo at 314-842-4442 or send him an email, tim@timkylo.com. Call State Farm agent and CBC alum Tim Kylo for all your insurance needs. Tim and the State
Class Sports Performance at the Lab Gym, St. Louis's premier training facility for elite and developmental athletes. Do you want to maximize your athletic potential? Do you want to get bigger, faster, stronger, more powerful, and actively prevent injuries? From high school and college to professional and Olympic athletes, world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym will get you ready to compete at the highest level. Call Director of Sports Performance, Matt Miller, at 314-932-7270 or visit their website, labgym.com. Or just stop into the gym at 5035 Manchester Avenue to see for yourself.
Hey guys, this is Matt Miller, world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym. Make sure to check us out online, stop by, get a free tour. If you mention you're a friend of CBC, you get a two-week free trial. So come get better, maximize your athletic potential.
Julio's Pizzeria and Tapas offers the best of Mediterranean cuisine with a full menu of classic Italian fare, traditional Spanish entrees, and tapas. Guido's delivers a taste of Spain in the middle of Italy. Try their made-to-order dishes, like Guido's homemade lasagna and the rich caramelized flan. Located on the heart of the hill at 5046 Shaw Boulevard, Guido's is open 7 days a week, till midnight on Friday and Saturday, until 11 p.m. on Sunday through Thursday. The Cadet Student Network loves to stop in and see owner and CBC alum Miguel Carretero, class of 86. You should do the same. Holy cannoli, you gotta try Guido's Pizzeria and Tapas on the hill.
We're back live at DC Wilcutt Gymnasium. We're about ready to start the third quarter. CBC leads at halftime, 31-21. You're watching the DC Wilcutt basketball tournament live on the Cadet Student Network. My name is Randy Bowman. I'm alongside CBC Director of Admissions Jim Brockman joining me for this afternoon's broadcast. And Jim, CBC, it doesn't seem like they're up 10 points, but here they are up 10 points at halftime.
Yeah, like I said to you earlier, it sure escalated quickly. Lutheran North pulled within four, about three minutes to go in the second quarter. And from there, we inserted Jordan Barnes back into the lineup. And it simply restores order. And that's what a good point guard, that's what you want to see out of a good point guard. He restores order. He controls the game. Certainly has the ball on a string, looks like a yo-yo. It's just really impressive to see how everything flows once Jordan Barnes is in the game. And certainly then we exploded for six quick points, and we're up 10.
The thing about Jordan Barnes that I mentioned last year, and I'll mention it here again to you today after this will be my second game doing play-by-play for CBC this year. The thing about Jordan Barnes is everything he does is so smooth and easy. It's not frenetic. It's not frantic. And the next thing you know, he's got 18 points and 6-8 assists. I mean, it's quiet every time, but it's not quiet. You know what I mean?
Yep. I was going to say, if it's a possibility to score a quiet 18 points, he'll do it. He'll hit a couple threes. He'll hit a couple layups. All of a sudden, he'll make about five free throws, and bam, he's there. He's in double digits.
We're underway in the third quarter, and there's the backdoor alley-oop once again. The pass was a little off, or Leslie jumped a little early. I couldn't tell which. Either way, no basket, but a foul. Leslie will go to the line.
Yeah, certainly don't ever want to say that Jordan Barnes threw a pass that was a little off. But I think he was a little behind Kenny Leslie. Kenny had to catch it kind of behind his head and kind of cockeyed behind him. It would have been an impressive knockdown if he were able to throw that down.
First foul called there on number 34. That was Barry Dorsey for Lutheran North. First team foul of the second half. Leslie will bury both free throws.
Yeah, that's a good set piece right out of the break. See if you can get your team ignited and maybe turn up the pressure a little bit and make a run here in the third quarter.
Gauss drives to the elbow. Now looking around, he'll get it back out. There's a three from the wing, no good. And a long rebound Foxworth grabs. Gets it to Barnes in the front court. Barnes now to the corner. Christian Willis. Double team, kicks it back out. That's Powell just inside the three-point line. Will now pick up his dribble and get it back to Barnes. Barnes guarded by Henderson. Drives into him a little with the shoulder. Kicks it back out. Powell back to Barnes. Left open. He'll fire up the three. A little short. And it's pulled down. Powell with the rebound, and CBC maintains control.
That's very impressive to see a guard rebound like that amongst all those big guys.
Jacob Foxworth had his hands on it too. So CBC either way, there's a long cross-court pass for Barnes who misses the three. Foxworth tries to put it up, and we're going to get a jump ball. Look at this CBC lineup here in the second half. You got the great swing man Willis, the two big men, Foxworth and Dorsey, and then Barnes and Powell.
This is a pretty formidable lineup right here with the big guys.
Size and lots of ability and agility out there.
A lot of ability to shoot the ball, too. That really spreads the team out.
Goldman now for Lutheran North. It now bounces back out to Derek Henderson. Henderson now over. And we're going to get a foul call there on Dorsey. Dorsey was driving in. CBC will get called with the foul, and it looks like it'll be number 10.
That's Jared Powell. Yeah, Powell kind of grabbed him as he drove by him. Didn't know he had support from Kenny Leslie behind him, so he kind of gave him a grab.
Second personal. First team foul of the half called on CBC. There it is underneath, looking for some room, trying to operate, can't do it. Good defense there by Foxworth and Leslie, and it's back to Foxworth on the give and go from Barnes. Two for Foxworth. He's got four.
That's incredibly impressive for the big man to run the floor, get the little easy basket there, and then get back down.
Gauss coming up the floor now for Lutheran North to Henderson. Henderson, Barnes, a little too handsy, I think, with the left hand.
Yep, the old hand check. Got him with the hand. Was able to wedge him away from the ball and steal the ball, but the referee wasn't buying it.
Brendan Sumrall, who left the game in the first quarter, has never returned, and so I hope that young man is okay for Lutheran North.
Looked relatively benign when it happened, but certainly don't want to speculate on the injury at all.
Oh, yeah.
Yep.
He leaned back. That was Gauss. Had the ball, had possession. CBC pressured him as he was on his seat on the floor, and when he leaned backwards, it's now an over and back.
Yeah,
ball.
Once that ball breaks that plane, it's over and back. So
hard to tell where he was on the floor, I guess, when he was just laying on his back, or at least sitting up anyway. CBC now in the front court with a 14-point lead, 35-21, 4-0 here in the third quarter. Powell, deep right wing, sets it to Barnes. Barnes underneath to Leslie, who will pull up in front of the elbow, and he'll get it to go.
Yeah, that's one of those you got to pick your poison. If you're going to pressure the wings out at the three-point line, you got to be prepared to get beat in the side, either between Foxworth or Leslie, or if Cale Catchings is in there.
Gauss, he's going to go coast to coast. Look at Gauss.
Gets the touch, gets the lay-in. That was very, very impressive. CBC had a little token pressure, and Gauss was able to break the pressure on his own and lay it in.
That'll give him 9 points on the afternoon, and a timeout called by Willis as Henderson had him tied up. Good timeout there. You don't want to make a mistake and turn the ball over.
Yeah, great defensive stand there by Henderson. Was able to get Kristen Willis trapped in the corner and picked up his dribble right as he came across the timeline. I think that's one of the first things you tell a guard, don't pick up your dribble across the timeline. Nonetheless, he did that. They overplayed the passing lanes, and Christian had to call a timeout.
Tatum having a candid conversation with Willis over there, and it wouldn't surprise me if he said that exact thing that you were just saying.
Yep.
When you need an attorney, you want someone you can count on to protect your legal rights, the attorneys at Milliken Wright are here for you. Brian Milliken and CBC grad Chris Wright have fiercely represented the injured and accused in civil and criminal cases in the St. Louis metro area for more than 15 years. Call Brian and Chris, 314-621-0622, or find Milliken Wright online, millikenwright.com. Milliken Wright will fight for you. Barnes has Leslie open, and he feeds the big fella, and he goes in and lays it in off the glass.
Yeah, this may be one of CBC's most effective lineups right here with Cale Catchings and Kenny Leslie, and then, of course, Jarek Powell and Jordan Barnes and Christian Willis. There you go, forcing the turnover.
Henderson with a pass at the feet of Barry Dorsey, and he couldn't handle it. Goes out of bounds. CBC will inbound, leading 39-23. 4:38 remaining, third quarter.
Yeah, Tatum's going to try to stretch the lead here and maybe let his guys rest for the remainder of the game. They had a big weekend, and they've got a big week this week as well. So
Powell kicks it out to Catchings. Catchings at the top of the key, sends it over to Barnes. Barnes left wing, Barnes now to Leslie, who's out top. Underneath the Catchings with the right hand, baby hook, no good. Leslie comes in and grabs the rebound. He's blocked. He pulls down the rebound again, kicks it out to Catchings. Catchings at the elbow underneath the Powell. Back to Willis for three, and he misses. But how about the passing there from the CBC Cadets looking for that extra pass to fire up an open shot?
Yeah, that's everything you wanted. I mean, you got a great look out of your one of your team leaders. That's all you can ask for. You just couldn't knock the shot down.
Underneath now to Betts. Betts down in the lane. He gets fouled. That's going to be on Leslie, I think.
Yep.
No, they're calling it on Catchings. Okay. Catchings will get his third.
And that's one of the benefits of having a deep bench. I mean, certainly you don't want to lose a guy like Cale Catchings, but the Cadets do have a deep bench, and so they can afford to maybe play with Cale Catchings a little bit longer than, say, another team would be able to.
Here's Goldman at the top now. Wheels it around to Henderson. Henderson trapped down low. He'll send it back across to Gauss. He comes and gets it. Gauss sends it to the corner. There's a three ball from the left corner. No good. Leslie grabs a rebound, brings it up. Jordan Barnes takes it in a great feed to Catchings, who almost had a spectacular layup. Leslie grabbed the rebound, gets fouled. He'll go to the line.
I think Cale was surprised that pass made it through there. It was almost exactly where we were sitting. You could see the lane open up, and Jordan made an incredible pass. And I think Cale was kind of surprised by it and short-armed the layup, but Kenny Leslie, man, Johnny on the spot there.
I've now seen Jordan Barnes for a couple of years, and I am still surprised at his court vision.
Yeah, he does. He sees everything.
He sees it before it happens. That's what great point guards do.
Exactly. I mean, that's what you expect out of a top-flight D1 level prospect point guard.
Leslie hits the second, so he's now 4-for-4 from the line, and a total of 12 points for Kenny Leslie.
Yeah, Kenny is actually added some points here in the second half to help the Cadets expand their lead.
Lutheran North into the front court now. Goldman at the top of the key. He feeds down low to Betts. Betts hops, fires. Leslie blocks him. Betts comes back. Reverse underneath. and no good. Nice move by Betts, but too much pressure from the CBC defense. Barnes will now take it in, and he'll now back it out.
Betts and Leslie have taken turns blocking each other. I think they each have three blocks on each other.
Catching's at the top of the key now. We'll wheel it around to Willis, who's left open, and he'll take the three, misses. High rebound. Catchings goes up and gets it. Goes in for the layup. No good, but he's fouled. He'll go to the line.
That's one of the things. If I'm Lutheran North's coach, Duron Lowe, I'm over telling my guys on these three-point shots, we've got to get bodies on people. And they're not getting bodies on people. CBC has gotten 5 second-chance opportunities off of three-point misses.
Barion Russell Clemens was called with the foul, his first. Catchings hits the free throw. CBC so far perfect from the line. 7 for 7 thus far.
Yeah, and that's for any team that's going to make a run in the postseason, that's what you want to see. You got to know that your guys can step up and hit it, including the freshman who hits two.
Catchings now with 10 points. 43-23, a 20-point lead and a 12-2 run to start the second half for CBC.
Yeah, that certainly escalated very quickly, but you can imagine Coach Tatum probably had some words for his guys at halftime.
Missed there, rebound with off the glass, no good. Leslie fights for the rebound. CBC back the other way. Jordan Barnes into the front court. Guarded by Russell Clemens. He pulls it back out to Catchings. Catchings looks, feeds underneath. Good pass, but Barnes wasn't ready to shoot it. He feeds it to Leslie, who is. And Leslie now has 14 on that assist from Barnes.
When you got a guy that's 6'7 and can knock down a shot like that from the wing, it's just so dangerous and so deadly.
Looks like Sam Orff's going to get called for that one. That's his first.
Yeah, a little aggressive with the hands and the body there, trying to, I mean, doing everything he can to stay in front of Derek Henderson, who's just so quick out there.
Going to be a timeout called here on the floor. CSN thanks all our sponsors like the Lab Gym on Manchester Road, Millpaws Piping and Supply, Let's Party Now Catering, and Guido's Pizzeria and Tapas. These loyal businesses make this broadcast possible, so be sure to support our sponsors. The CBC Alumni Association and our admissions department also sponsor CSN. We appreciate their support. My name's Randy Molman, Jim Brockman alongside. We're bringing you CBC basketball on the Cadet Student Network at a 45-23 lead. How about 14-2 to open up the second half for the Cadets?
As a coach, that's what you want. I mean, you want your guys to come out and make a statement, especially when you're the higher-seeded team, the number one seed in your own tournament, a tournament that you want to, you know, win. You've got to make an opening round statement. And I think the malaise had worn off by halftime, and the Cadets are ready to play now.
Henderson into the front court for Lutheran North. Dribbles between the legs, into the paint, goes up, no good. Foxworth grabs the rebound. Orff comes the other way for CBC to Bomarito, back to Orff. Ball tipped by Henderson. Orff grabs it, maintains possession. Foxworth sets the screen. Orff to Foxworth on the give and go. Boy, is that nice.
That is just so good by Sam Orff and Jacob Foxworth there. Great two-man game, a little screen, a little roll, and a two-point basket.
Executed perfectly. Henderson now, deep right wing, sends it off. Driving into the lane, looking for the left hand, can't do it. Kicks it back out to Henderson. Top of the key, long three, he drills it.
Oh, that was deep right there, baby. That was college there. Good for Henderson. He's been really quiet in the second half so far. He's handling the ball, but I think the Cadets are putting a lot of pressure on him.
Long pass to Bomarito, goes up with the scoop layup. How about Blake Bomarito with two? That's 5 points total for him today.
Yeah.
Under a minute to go, third quarter, 49-26, check that. CBC on top. Henderson fouled. Let's see who they call it on.
Catchings, I
could
think.
Be on either. They're going to get Catchings. That's his fourth.
Yeah. And again, a good learning experience for the young fellows. First DC Wilcutt tournament experience here, and certainly playing in front of a bunch of his classmates right after school here. So they're going to probably get him out pretty quickly. You know, he's not a piece you want to lose.
That was a miscommunication there. Number 32, Mingo, was coming underneath on the inbound and read well by Foxworth the other way. Ball goes out of bounds. It'll be CBC's ball. Willis will check in for Catchings now, who does have the four fouls. And Christian Willis returns.
this is a great opportunity for guys like Sam Worf and Blake Bomarito and even like Lee Richmond to get a little bit of time here, especially Sam to try to knock the shot down here. Oh.
Worf misses the free throw, but we're going to get an offensive foul called on CBC. Pushed off to grab the rebound. Looks like they're going to get Willis. Henderson will take a break for Lutheran North. Number 10, Henry Kukendall has checked in. Kukendall, first action of the day for him.
Yeah, Henderson's got to be worn out, man. He's pretty much done a lot of the ball handling, a lot of the on-ball defending today.
Kukendall now pressured. Sends it across. Ball tipped by Orff. The thing about CBC, their hands always active, always quick on defense.
And Coach Tatum teaches that, just active hands, active rebounding.
Kukendall misses the three. Orff tries to grab the rebound and can't. They go almost tumbling into the crowd. Lutheran North maintains possession.
Yeah, Sam Orff, just a sophomore, but excellent on-the-ball defender. And although he hasn't shown it here today, he's an excellent shooter as well.
The Crusaders down 49-26, under 10 to play here in the third quarter. Kukendall now looking. They're looking for a three ball. It's fired up, and it's good. That was Barry Dorsey who drills the three from deep. Cuts the lead to 20, and that'll be your halftime score, or I'm sorry, your third quarter score, 49-29 Cadets, as we head to the final 8 minutes, Jim.
Yeah, and if you're looking, you know, I mean, as you watch tonight, I mean, the Cadets are obviously up 20. There's a good chance that it's going to be very difficult for Lutheran North to, overtake the Cadets in the fourth quarter. Nonetheless, what you want to see out of your Cadets, if you're Coach Tatum, you want to make sure they don't get sloppy. They continue to play good, solid, fundamental basketball, because while you might be able to get away with sloppy play here right now, you absolutely will not get around it in the next round or in the finals of this tournament. So if you have the aspirations of winning, you got to continue to stay sharp. He's probably going to try to get some guys minutes here in the fourth quarter as well, try to keep those guys sharp with some game time, and maybe rest some of his big guys like Kenny Leslie and Jacob Foxworth, of course, Jordan Barnes as well.
I would think in the beginning 2-3 minutes of this quarter, Coach Tatum will want to see him just go for the throat, so to speak, and really, you know, put this game away for good in the first couple of minutes so that he can do what you said, and that's get some depth into this game, get some experience, get some guys out there to get some game time.
Yeah, I think you'd want to try to stretch this lead to maybe 10, or an additional 10, so stretch it to 30 and then get your guys in and let your bench play.
Orff, Bomarito, Foxworth, Willis, and Richmond on the floor for CBC here to start the fourth quarter. Orff to Willis. Willis at the top of the key now leans left, hands it over to Richmond. Richmond dribbles in, kicks it back out. Foxworth will not shoot that long three. Bomarito now will step in at the elbow, kick it to Willis. Willis at the top of the key for CBC. Leading 49-29, fourth quarter action just underway. Orff between the leg dribble on the crossover, and he's blocked. Betts with another block. That's got to be at least five for him today.
I think that is five, Randy. Five blocks for Betts, three of which have been on Kenny Leslie. So it's been a block fest for Betts today.
They're going to call a foul before the shot, and on CBC. Looks like they're going to get number 12. That's going to be on Orff. That's his second team foul. Seventh, which means to the line, shooting a 1-1 here for Lutheran North, is 34. That's Barry Dorsey.
You've got Leslie Barnes and Jarek Powell who have now checked back into the game. So I think you're going to see Coach Tatum try to stretch this out a little bit before he brings the other guys in.
Dorsey at the free throw line. First free throw of the afternoon is good. That gives him 7 points on the game for Barry Dorsey.
They're averaging just over 9 points a game, so it's close to his average right now.
Second free throw, good. 49-31 in favor of CBC, 7-18 and counting here in the fourth quarter. Barnes will bring it up. He hands it to Orff. Orff will cross the timeline now with approaching 7 minutes to play in this game.
It's interesting to see Orff running the point with Jordan Barnes on the floor here. Nonetheless, Coach Tatum may be trying something different here.
Different looks. Orff on the baseline. And another block by Betts as Dorsey tried the put back. Here comes Dorsey the other way. Count the basket. And he bangs his head on the stands. Hope he's okay underneath the hoop over there. Barry Dorsey with an athletic move for his 7th and 8th points.
And another block by Austin Betts. What a heck of a game this guy's having tonight. Leads the team with 8 blocks, but, man, he's darn near doubled that total here tonight.
Only 4 points, but, man, defensively looking very good is Austin Betts. Dorsey misses the free throw. 2 of 3 on the afternoon, and CBC comes back the other way. 49-33 for the Cadets. This is Barnes. Dribbles to the elbow and drills it. 2 points there for Barnes, 5 on the night.
He is so dangerous from that little mid-range jumper. Really a lost art in the basketball game.
Really
it's that mid-range jumper, but, man, he is so deadly, and he can get it at almost any time he wants.
Barnes aggressive defensively on Gauss. He gets it across. Firing up a 2-ball, no good, just inside the 3, and it's grabbed finally by Powell, who gets it to Willis on the run, kicks it to Barnes, 3 from the corner, and can't make that go down. Long rebound for Lutheran North. They come the other way. This is Gauss into the front court. Underneath the Betts. Betts right in the paint. Looks like another timeout called on by Lutheran North, and this lead is now cut to 16.
Yeah, all of a sudden, Coach Lowe maybe has his guys believing a little bit here. And again, as a coach, you're down 20. You start talking to your guys about chipping away. We're not going to get we don't got a 20-point shot here. Make the game interesting if we did. So let's chip away. Let's try to get this by 5 minutes. Let's try to get this thing below 15. You know, by 3 minutes, let's try to get it to 10. You know, and then you start having conversations about stealing one. It's fun to do that. I mean, those are the little things that you can do when you are losing. You can kind of find ways, different ways to encourage your players. It's, you know, and here they are. They're down 16.
If you want to maximize your athletic potential, join world-class sports performance at the Lab Gym on Manchester Road. Matt Miller and his team train high school, college, professional, and even Olympic athletes. He gets you ready to compete at the highest level. Mention the Friends of CBC discount offer, and you'll receive a 2-week free trial of sports performance training. Call Matt, 314-932-7270. Or visit their website, labgym.com/sports. My name is Randy Molman. I'm alongside CBC Director of Admissions, Jim Brockman. We're giving you CBC basketball at the DC Wilcutt Tournament right here from the DC Wilcutt Gymnasium. Game one of the tournament, of a week-long tournament. And CBC up 51-35 here in the fourth quarter over the Lutheran North Crusaders.
Little full-court trap here for Lutheran North, trying to cause a turnover, get a quick two here. CBC able to break it, though.
Barnes will settle everything down, and he'll back down his man. Now take it with the left hand to the top of the key, kick it over to Christian Willis. Willis back to Barnes. Barnes being guarded by Gauss. He'll now send it over to Powell. Powell down the right side. Tried to feed Leslie. Leslie wasn't ready. He was going to set a screen. And the ball kicked off his leg, and Lutheran North the other way. Leslie grabs the rebound. And Goldman knocks it out of bounds with the left hand.
Yeah, that was a force by Gauss there. He really should have pulled it back out. I know he wanted to score in transition, maybe catch a little momentum there, but really was ill-advised. It was 1-on-3. He needed to pull that out and get a better shot.
Christian Willis now gets it up to Leslie. Poked away. Good defensive play on the lazy pass. Gauss underneath. That's the right hand of number 21, bearing on Russell Clemens. That gives him 5.
And if I'm Coach Lowe, I said, let's get it under 15 at 5 minutes. It's under 15 at 5 minutes.
Barnes blocked. Leslie's blocked again by Betts. That's his 6th or 7th block, maybe.
That's 7 blocks.
7
for Betts.
Blocks.
Austin Betts almost doubled his total. Coming into the game, he had 8 blocks on the season. He's got 7 here tonight.
Catchings has now fouled out. That was his foul there, 5th, and he is gone. Either Bomarito, looks like Bomarito's going to check in for Catchings, and now Foxworth will also check in for Leslie to the line. That's the 9th team foul for CBC, and to the line, Christian Gauss.
If Gauss knocks these down, we're in a ball game here, boys.
14-point lead, make it 13 as he hits the first.
If you're Coach Lowe, this is what you want right now. Let's get this thing to 10, and then we're going to talk again.
Second free throw from Gauss is off the back iron, no good. Foxworth grabs the rebound. CBC the other way. A little full court pressure from the Crusaders. Bomarito will now pull up for a three, and he drills it. Blake Bomarito with three from the corner. 8 points.
Wow, that is impressive. That young man in transition squared and shot and knocked it down in this situation. Wow, that's very good.
They left him alone, and he thought, you know, they're going to leave me alone, I'm going to take it. Good idea.
It's always that a good idea off. When it goes in, by the way.
Barnes ahead to Willis. Willis the other way with the left hand. They're going to call it offensive.
Yeah, he got there. He did a nice job to slide his feet and get set up there. It looked like Betts again. Yes, it was Betts. Betts is having himself a game here tonight. He was able to slide his feet, get established under the basket. There's no halo rule under in high school, and Willis ran right into him.
Christian Gauss brings the ball up for Lutheran North. Stops his dribble, maintains possession. Barnes with great defense there. Dorsey now dribbles in, pulls it back out, fires up a three, no good. Rebound by Foxworth. Finally gets it to Barnes. Barnes brings it the other way, and the pressure does not bother Jordan Barnes. Cross court for Bomarito, no good. Barnes with the easy rebound, a long rebound. Now they fire to him for the corner, and he almost puts down a three. Goldman grabs the rebound. CBC will get called with the foul.
Shooting two.
And he'll be shooting two. 10th team foul. Double bonus for Lutheran North.
You know, CBC's really struggled shooting three-pointers. I think they've only knocked three down, two of which have been by Blake Bomarito. Very, very struggled from there. They're usually pretty strong from three as well.
So the only other three was by Barnes in the first quarter.
There you go.
So, yes, Sam Orff has attempted a few. I know Barnes has attempted a few.
Willis a few.
So struggling from the three-point line, but still leading 54-39 are the CBC Cadets with 3:40 to play. One of two there for Goldman. CBC comes back the other way. Christian Willis into the front court.
Did it again.
Pulls up his dribble again, and the ball is knocked out of bounds. Justin Tatum giving him the stare down, Coach Tatum.
Again, not typically a point guard. Not typically a point guard. You don't want him picking up that dribble across the timeline.
Barnes guarded by Russell Clemens. And there's a foul as the ball was fed into Foxworth. A foul called there on Malik Mingo.
Yeah, Mingo just a little aggressive on the post defense there as Jacob had established excellent position down low, and they tell you do your work early and get your reap rewards later, and certainly he had done that, and Mingo took the foul instead of giving up the basket.
Betts returns, Mingo out, Foxworth off the glass, another great inbounds play there by CBC.
That's one thing Coach Tatum really, really does well. Those set pieces off the inbound. It's just really impressive. Fun to watch.
There's a long three from the top of the key. No good. That ball comes out and grabbed by Leslie, and it hits out of bounds. They're going to give it to Lutheran North. Very good call there by the official.
Right on top of it. These guys have been great tonight. Have made very, very solid calls. Been consistent all night.
56-39 CBC, 3 minutes to go. My name's Randy Molman. Jim Brockman alongside. We're bringing you all the action of the DC Wilcutt Tournament here from the DC Wilcutt Gymnasium, and your CBC Cadets lead 56-39 fourth quarter. Barnes drives into the paint, kicks it out, back to Barnes, underneath the Leslie. Spin move with the left hand, no good. Foxworth grabs the rebound and is fouled. I mean, poor Austin Betts. He's having such a great night, but now he's got to deal with Leslie and Foxworth.
That's a lot of guy down there trying to fend off the basket. And again, Kenny did a great job of establishing a low post presence. That's one of the things that Coach Tatum teaches, of course, being a post himself.
Yep.
Teaches him establish post early. Beat your man down the floor and establish post early.
Foxworth makes his free throw. We got a few changes now. Checking in, number 21, Lee Richmond. Number 12, Sam Orff. Foxworth back to the line. Jacob misses. He has 9 points on the night, 1 for 2 from the line.
Yeah, it's been a solid game for Jacob. Jacob's got a handful of rebounds, some blocks. I mean, he has had a very, very solid game here tonight. He's been very much a key component of what the Cadets have been able to do tonight.
Or fouls his man going after the rebound. That was Goldman. Goldman will now go to the line. Kyle Goldman, number 24.
Yeah, and if you're Coach Tatum, this is absolutely what you don't want to see is Lutheran North shooting free throws at this point. I mean, you want to get this game over with.
Goldman came in averaging 4.2.
Just a 53% free throw shooter right on average there, 1 out of 2.
It's 1 out of 2 once again. He's got 3 points, 3 of 6 from the line, and that ball is going to go the other way. Lutheran North gets it.
Yeah, Cadets a little sloppy there. I think they're starting to think about Wednesday right now and threw that one away.
Ethan Goddard checks in for the Cadets.
Yeah, old Ethan Goddard gets some time here off the bench.
Henderson feeds Gauss. Gauss looking. They give him the baseline. He takes it, and Goddard is called with the foul.
Had to get himself in the stat sheet, so people knew he was in. But, no, Ethan's one of those kids, just a tremendous kid. I had him in class. Tremendous kid, works very hard. This is the type of kid you want on your team, that he makes others better, and that's what you want to say about these guys coming off the bench.
Gauss at the line hits the first one.
He plays tough defense. He simulates the other team. I mean, he does a very, very good job. It's great to see him getting minutes right now.
And hits both. Gauss 3 for 4 from the line, 13 points for Lutheran North. Full court pressure here from the Crusaders trying to create some turnovers. Richmond will fire it ahead to Goddard. Goddard underneath to Foxworth. Misses the layup, grabs his own rebound, is fouled, and he makes that one go.
Foxworth just padding his rebound stats down there, missing the bunny and putting it right back up.
So he'll get the rebound and the bucket after missing the initial layup, and he'll go to the line.
I'm going
to
make mention of this nice dish by Ethan Goddard there. Should have had an assist on the stat sheet, and Jacob missed the chippy.
Completes the three-point play. 2 of 3 from the line for Foxworth and 12 points. So the big men, Leslie with 14, Foxworth with 12.
Boy, not to be lost in this whole shuffle has been Austin Betts, a seven block performance tonight.
Henderson drills the three, his second of the game. He now has 9 points. And with 1:58 to go, it's down to a 15-point lead for CBC. Give Lutheran North credit. They are not going away. They're playing tough right now.
Yeah, and Coach Lowe obviously knows this game's pretty much in hand, barring something crazy. Nonetheless, you're coaching for Wednesday. You're coaching for districts. You're coaching for, you know, he's got young guys on that squad. So you're coaching for all those situations as well. You know, you want them. They don't get the opportunity to be in these situations, and there's no way you can replicate this in practice. So get him some game time. He's over there telling him, hey, let's see if we can get this to 10. We got a minute 58. Let's see if we get this to 10.
That's one of the things that I do that aggravates me when I'm at basketball games and fans are upset when you're down a certain number of points. You know you're not coming back and their coach is calling timeout. They're not calling timeout necessarily for this game. They're calling timeout to work on things that they need to work on going forward.
That timeout that was just spent is a timeout that's going to be important in districts.
Absolutely.
You know? And so I absolutely have no problem. The other part of this is these kids got to play. Let them play the game. And we can stand here and dribble the ball with the front court the whole time. But let these kids play. They practice too hard not to get some time.
Orff grabs the pass. Now he's being pressured. He loses the ball, and we're going to get a jump.
Great job.
They'll call a jump ball. Good defense there from Lutheran North, and then good hustle at the end by the Cadets to make sure they didn't lose possession.
Yeah, the frenetic pace that Lutheran North plays with when they do trap is deadly. The problem is they can't do that for the entire game. And so it's got to come in spurts like this. And when they do it, it's very difficult to break.
Henderson gets the inbound. He'll bring it up for Lutheran North. The Crusaders' point guard. Now he gets trapped back by. Oh, they're going to call a foul first.
Ooh, potentially a little aggressive on Lee Richmond there, although I thought it was clean. I thought it was knocked away. But nonetheless, they're going to get him on the hand check.
Yep, so Lee Richmond gets called, and Henderson will go to the line and shoot free throws. 3 for 4 from the line here. 9 points on the night for the point guard. Make it 10.
And we talked about him having a quiet first half points-wise. He's really picked it up in the second half, points-wise at least. He's had a major impact on the game. I mean, these are things that you don't see in the stat sheets. The ball deflections, the on-the-ball defending, things that aren't going to pick up in the stat sheet. But he's had a tremendous game.
Makes both. 5 for 6 from the line for Henderson.
Yes.
Orff takes the inbound. Ooh, and that ball's knocked away. It'll stay with CBC. Peter Nowicki is going to have to be stronger with the hands on those passes that he gets.
Yeah, it certainly is happening quick. So he's got to be strong with the passes. You got to be confident with what you're doing. You got to dribble with purpose.
And hard to sit on the bench all game and then come in and play an aggressive defense like Lutheran North is playing right now.
Certainly is difficult. Nice play, though,
Nowicki
there.
Nowicki to Goddard. Goddard brings it into the front court. He's going to get trapped, and he sends it down to Foxworth, who will kick it back out to number 21. That's Lee Richmond. Richmond to Orff. Orff trapped again, and boy, they are really giving Orff a lot of trouble. Every time he gets the ball, they are converging on Orff like bees to honey.
I certainly didn't know if he was going to make that call or not. I'm thinking, certainly that, well, that's a, okay, there he is, finally called that foul. I was waiting for it, where Sam Orff, I think, was even a little dismayed.
1-1, and Orff misses the front end, but put back by Foxworth.
Foxworth just patting stats now.
Lutheran North the other way. Good spin move by Gauss. He'll pull it back out.
Yeah, Goddard almost with the steal there.
In the corner for 3. No good off the back iron, and Peter Nowicki grabs the rebound. And an ill-advised pass after a good defensive effort by Goldman. Goldman misses the layup. Goddard goes and grabs the rebound, number 22, and there'll be a foul called on Lutheran North. The Crusaders bench not happy with that call.
Yeah, it looked like, I mean, dare I say, a 50-50 ball. Two guys going at it, and Henderson ended up on the floor and the foul.
62-47 CBC, 41.4 remaining, fourth quarter. First game of the DC Wilcutt tournament. Live from DC Wilcutt Gymnasium on the campus of CBC High School. My name's Randy Molman, Jim Brockman alongside, and CBC 41 seconds away from closing out a first-round victory.
Yeah, let's see if Ethan Goddard can knock these two down, get himself a couple points here.
Shooting the front end of the one-on-one, or 1-1, no good. Rebound there by Nowicki. Nowicki throwing elbows around.
Yeah, I certainly glad he called that. I don't know exactly what he called, but nonetheless, I thought one more of those might have clipped somebody, and then we would have had a whole different problem.
Henderson will take the inbound for Lutheran North. They'll bring it up from your left to your right. Drives into the paint. Kit dishes it to Goldman. Goldman was not ready, and ball goes out of bounds.
Yeah, that's a good point guard. A good point guard tells his guys, always be ready because you never know where it's coming from.
Absolutely. 34.7 remaining. 62-47 in favor of CBC. Good inbound play, and here come the Cadets. Sam Orff into the front court. He'll drive into the paint. He'll take it himself with the left hand, and a layup there for Sam Orff. He gets on the board. That's his first 2 points, believe it or not.
Yeah, he's played most of the game, and it came in the last minute of the game. He gets his first two.
Henderson fires a 3. That's short. Goldman grabs the rebound. He'll fire up a 3 from the top of the key, and he drills it. That's Kyle Goldman, and a timeout called by the Crusaders. 14 points. CBC lead 64-50, 10.4 remaining. If you want to, cadet fans, if you know a grade school student who might be a future cadet, please encourage them to pay us a visit. Experience CBC for themselves. A shadow visit's the best way to do that. Great things are happening at CBC every day. Seventh grade shadowing now available. Call Mrs. Melissa Ryan to schedule your shadow visit or a private family tour of CBC. That's 314-985-6095 for Mrs. Melissa Ryan. Make your plans to pay CBC a visit. Once again, 314-985-6095. Spend the day with us and experience what CBC is all about. And don't forget to join us for the 2015 CBC Father-Son Banquet, Wednesday, January 28th at the Westport Chalet. St. Louis Cardinals President Bill DeWitt III is our special guest speaker. So sign up now at the Parents Club website. That's www.parentsclubcbc.com. Fathers, uncles, grandfathers, friends, you're all welcome. Reserve a spot. ParentsClubCBC.com.
Nice job breaking the press there by this second line of guys. And there it is.
That's your final score. The CBC Cadets win their round one match here in the DC Wilcutt Tournament over the Lutheran North Crusaders. The final score was 64-50. And before we call it quits and tell everyone to tune in again Wednesday at 3:30 as CBC will play their second round game, the Cadets, it felt like they had a comfortable lead for most of the second half, but give Lutheran North credit. They fought this entire game and the entire second half, even when they were down more than 20 points.
Certainly people talk about no moral victories, no character wins, no, you know. But in this case, I mean, that really was just a character go for Lutheran North there. I mean, they fought hard to the end. Coach Lowe was coaching to the end, called a timeout with 10 seconds to go to set up a press to try to get a steal to cut it from 15 to 12, you know. I mean, those are the things that you do with a young team. Those are the things that you do as you try to teach these young men how to play the game right. And that's very, very impressive.
And how about a win where Jordan Barnes unofficially only scores 5 points. That's a good team victory there here in round one.
Well, guys like Foxworth stepped up. I mean, he was absolutely huge today. Certainly Kenny Leslie got his. Christian Willis got on the board. There was a lot of different scores, and you like that. You want to see that. You know, you're going to have games where Jordan's going to score 27, i.e. the SLU game, but you definitely want to see games where guys, you know, can step up and take some of the burden off of Jordan and score. That's good. That makes us a dangerous team when another team's got to account for many different scorers.
Leslie and Foxworth, both with 14 points, and combined, they were 6 of 7 from the free throw line. So good work by the postmen for CBC. The Cadets win 64-50, and Jim, thank you for joining me.
It was awesome
the broadcast.
Man. Yeah, you're great.
You're going to be back on Wednesday with me?
I think so. I'm going to talk to you. I certainly got to talk to the boss at home, but I'd love to be here. It's a pleasure to do the game with you.
Sounds good. That's Jim Brockman. For Jim Brockman and for Tony Gambino and John Rolfe, who helped make the broadcast possible, station manager Josh Williams and exec producer Bryson Schroeder, we will be back here on Wednesday at 3:30 for CBC's second round game here in the DC Wilcutt Tournament. And the first round final, CBC 64, Lutheran North 50. And hope you enjoyed the broadcast as much as we enjoyed bringing it to you. Until Wednesday at 3:30. So long, everybody.